स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम एंड डूइंग हार्ड वर्क टू अचीव द गोल्स. स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस टू स्टैंडर्ड. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 10, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ इनकम एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट. इन दिस टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एग्रीगेट डिमांड एंड एग्रीगेट सप्लाई अप्रोच एंड कंजम्पशन फंक्शन, सेविंग फंक्शन, इन्वेस्टमेंट फंक्शन. टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ फुल एम्प्लॉयमेंट and involuntary unemployment and working of the multiplier. Let's start with the term full employment. Suppose there are 200 workers in a region. Everyone willing to work at the going wage rate is able to get a job. So full employment is an economic situation in which all available labor resources are being used in most efficient way possible. So full employment embodies the highest amount of skilled and unskilled labor that can be employed within an economy at any given time. This doesn't mean everyone of working age is in employment. Some adults may leave the labor force, for example, women looking after children. Somebody wants to change the job. Due to shifting of job, he has to appear for the training also, so he will quit the job. So in full employment situation, demand for labor, it is equals to the supply of labor at the given level of wage rate. Next one is structural unemployment. Under the structural unemployment, a form of unemployment caused by mismatch between the skills that workers in the economy can offer and the skills demanded of workers by employers. This kind of unemployment brought about by technological changes. When the laborers are trained by decaying industries instead of new upcoming industries, or when there is change in production, technology and nature of goods produced in the country, then structural unemployment exists. Now next one is frictional unemployment. Quitting a job voluntarily and join in some another sector, like the persons who were working in the farms, now they want to do the labor work in the industry. So frictional unemployment exists due to shifting of job, and it is a temporary unemployment. The presence of structural and frictional unemployment is referred as a natural rate of unemployment. Next one is disguised unemployment. When more workers are engaged in a work than actually required to work, like in farming, that is a disguised unemployment. Cyclical unemployment. This kind of unemployment is caused by slackness in business conditions. During depression, investment activities get discouraged. Contraction in business activities renders a large number of workers unemployed. Next one is voluntary unemployment. Suppose Rohan is selected as a chief engineer in some company, but he is not satisfied with his salary and location. So he decided that he will quit the job and wait for another opportunity. So voluntary unemployment means when the economy offers employment opportunity to the workers, but they themselves are not willing to take up jobs because of employment conditions such as wage rate, location, attitude of the employer, etc. Next one is involuntary unemployment. Ram is a software engineer and he didn't get any job in this field, but he is ready to do any kind of job but fails to get the job opportunity. So involuntary unemployment means when workers are willing to work under any condition at any wage rate but fails to get the employment. One thing more is here, children and old persons are not treated as unemployed as they are not able to do the work. Next one is investment multiplier. Let's understand the investment multiplier with the help of an example. Suppose an increase in investment by rupees 100 crore leads to an increase in the income by rupees 500 crore. So increase in income is calculated by change in income divided by the change in investment. So ratio of change in income over change in investment will give you the value 5. This 5 means that our income increased 5 times to the increase in investment. So the investment multiplier is defined as the ratio of the change in income to the change in investment. Symbolically, we can write K it is equals to delta Y upon delta I, where K means investment multiplier, delta Y means change in income, delta I means change in investment. The value of K it is equals to 5, which means that for any level of change in investment in the economy, income will change 5 times the investment amount. Thus, multiplier is a number with which when multiplied by the amount of change in investment gives us the change in the level of income. Now let's discuss the relationship between multiplier and marginal propensity to consume. The value of multiplier is determined by the size of marginal propensity to consume. As you know that marginal propensity to consume is the additional consumption from the additional income. Higher the additional consumption from the additional income, greater is the size of multiplier, means greater is the value of the additional income. Lower the MPC means when we will consume less of the additional income, lower is the value of the multiplier. We will get lower income. So the relationship between multiplier and marginal propensity to consume can be expressed as K is equals to 1 upon 1 minus MPC. Let's take an example to understand this. Suppose in an economy, consumption level is rupees 2 crore. When income was rupees 4 crore, with the increase in income up to rupees 8 crore, consumption also increased to rupees 5 crore. We have to find MPC and multiplier. As you know that marginal propensity to consume is the ratio of change in consumption due to change in income. We are having consumption level 2 crore when the income level was 4 crore. With the increase in income to 8 crore, our consumption level also increased to 5 crore. So delta C, change in consumption, that is 5 minus 2, 3 crore. That is current consumption minus previous consumption. Next one is delta Y, change in income. That is current income minus previous income will give you 4 crore change in income. So MPC is delta C 3 upon delta Y 4. 3 upon 4 will give you the value of 0.75. So this 0.75 means that this is the additional consumption from additional income. 75% of the additional income it is consumed. Now next one is, from here we can find the value of multiplier. That what is the effect of this much of consumption from the additional income on the multiplier, income multiplier. Now see, value of MPC is 0.75. After simplification, you will get the value 4. So it means that MPC, 75% consumption from the additional income, results are income increased 4 times. So we have to calculate multiplier K for the MPC's different values. Let's see what happened. MPC when it is equals to 0. At that time, the value of K it is calculated, it is equals to 1. When the MPC value we have supposed that 0.25, at that time the value of K it is equals to 1.3. And when the MPC it is equals to 0.50, at that time the value of the multiplier, our income increased twice. And when we have consumed 75% of the additional income, our income multiplier or our income increased 4 times. In the same way, when the marginal propensity to consume value it is equals to 1, at that time the value of multiplier it is equals to infinity. So it means that with the increase in the value of MPC, value of multiplier also increasing. See, at 0.8 MPC, multiplier value it is 5. When MPC it is equals to 1, multiplier value it is equals to infinity. So from this we can judge that there is a direct relationship between marginal propensity to consume and investment multiplier. Minimum value of multiplier it is equals to 1 when marginal propensity to consume it is equals to 0, and maximum value of k it is equals to infinity when marginal propensity to consume it is equals to 1. Now next one is, we know that marginal propensity to consume plus marginal propensity to save it is equals to 1. So from here we can derive the formula 1 minus MPC it is equals to MPS. And you know this formula also, that MPC it is equals to the ratio of change in consumption over change in income, and MPS is the ratio of change in savings upon change in income. So we can calculate multiplier with the help of MPS also, that is a inverse relationship between investment multiplier and marginal propensity to save. Let's take an example. Suppose in an economy, national income increases by rupees 500 crore. As a result, investment increased by rupees 125 crore. So MPC we can calculate like this. Firstly, we are having change in income and change in investment. So calculate this one first. 500 upon 125 will give you the value of multiplier, that is 4. So with the 125 crore investment, our income level increase 4 times. Now from here we know the value of investment multiplier, we can calculate the value of MPC. After the calculation we get the value of MPC, that is 0.75. Put this value of 0.75 to calculate MPC. MPS it is equals to 1 minus MPC. MPC value it is 0.75. So you will get the answer for MPS, it is equals to 0.25. Now next one is, suppose MPC value it is given to you, that is 0.50. Then the value of investment multiplier you can calculate it like this. 1 upon 1 minus 0.50 will give you 1 upon 0.50. This is equals to 100 upon 50, it is equals to 2. So when the marginal propensity to consume it is 50%, at that time the investment multiplier it is 2 times increase in the income. That is, now next one is, suppose value of MPC it is equals to 0.80. The same way you will fill the value of MPC and you can get the value of investment multiplier, that is equals to 5. So you can see when the value of MPC was 0.50, then the value of multiplier k it is equals to 2, and when the MPC it is 0.75 then k it is equals to 4, when MPC it is equals to 0.80 then k it is equals to 5. So with the increase in the value of MPC, value of investment multiplier K also increased. So positive relationship between MPC and K, that is investment multiplier. Now let's discuss the working of multiplier. Working on a multiplier based on the fact that one man's expenditure is another man's income. Suppose there is a pair of shoes in the market worth rupees 1000. And I will spend rupees 1000 for a pair of shoes. Rupees 1000 is my expenditure, but is the income to the shopkeeper. So one man's expenditure is the another man's income. Let's understand the multiplier working with the help of a table. Suppose there is an investment, increase in investment in the economy 100 crore, and increase in the income also 100 crore. And due to this increase in the income, there is an increase in the consumption, that is 75. इट मीन्स दैट 75% ऑफ द इंक्रीज इनकम वी हैव कंज्यूम्ड. नाउ वट इज सेव्ड विद अस और वट इज लेफ्ट विद अस, दैट इज 25. सो नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज वेन द दिस इज द एडिशनल इनकम इन द इकोनॉमी. One man's expenditure from the household side and income to the producer side. So now this one is an additional income, 75. Again, when the household will spend this additional income in the economy, you will get, he will save 25% of this additional income and rest it will consume in the economy. Now next one is, again this is the income, additional income of the consumer. So this additional income, again when additional consumption it is there, due to this additional income, again 75% it is consumed and 25% it will be saved. Now because every time 75% we are assuming that our MPC it is 0.75 only, that's why every time I'm multiplying with these numbers to the 3/4. Now next one is, in the same way we will calculate the additional consumption and additional income continuously, and this process will continue till the level will come where the change in income it is equals to the change in consumption. Now next one is, suppose there is initial increase in the investment worth rupees 100 crore in the economy. Suppose the value of MPC is 0.75 given. Due to increase in the investment, income also increase to rupees 100 crore as we have seen in the table of the producer. In the first round, consumption increased to rupees 75 crore. This increase in consumption of rupees 75 crore will be the increase in the income of the producer. So by rupees 75 crore, this additional income of rupees 75 crore will lead to the additional consumption of rupees 56.25 crore. As people spend this additional income of rupees 56.25 crores, it becomes the income of some other person. This process will continue till delta C it is equals to delta Y. Now next one we will discuss forward and backward working of multiplier. If an increase in investment of rupees 50 crore causes an increase in income by rupees 200 crore, it means that there is a forward action of multiplier. With this much of investment, our income increased to the 200 level. Now next one is, if the investment decreases by rupees 50 crore and as a result income decreases by rupees 200 crore, this is a backward action of multiplier. Next one is diagrammatical representation of this multiplier. I have taken this table of income. Income varies from 0 till 600. Consumption also varies with the increase in income. Here at 0 level of income, my consumption it is 100. So this is the autonomous consumption as it is the independent of level of income, and this consumption level it is the minimum expenditure for survival from our past saving. And our investment level, that is the autonomous investment, that is 100 in the economy. Now next one is, at 100 level of income, my consumption it is 150. So from here I can calculate savings. 0 minus 100 minus 100, 100 minus 150 minus 50, 200 minus 200 0, 300 minus 250 it is equals to 50. In this way you can calculate the saving. When you will mark these consumption and investment and savings on the scale, that is we will measure on the x-axis income and on the y-axis we will measure saving and investment. So at 0 level of income, my investment it is at 100 level. At 100 level of income, investment is 100. 200 level of income, investment is 100. 300 level of income, investment is 100. After joining all these points, I will get a horizontal straight line parallel to x-axis I naught, that is autonomous investment. And the saving curve, that is at 0 level of income minus 100, At 100 level of income, savings are minus 50. At 200 level of income, savings are 0. At 300 level of income, savings are 50. In this way, I will mark all these points and join these points, get a upward sloping saving curve that will intersect the investment curve at point E1. So this is the equilibrium point with the economy. Suppose there is increase in investment from 100 to 200 crore in the economy. And when I will mark these points at 0 level of income, 200 investment, 100 level of income, 200 investment, 200 level of income, 200 investment, 300 level of income, 200 investment. After joining all these points, I will get the another investment curve I1 that will intersect with the saving curve at point E2. And you can see with the increase in investment, income also increase. But increase in the income, it is more than the increase in investment. Now I0 is the original investment curve which intersects the saving at point E1. With the increase in the investment or to I1 level, that is I1 level, equilibrium level of income also shift from OA to OB, that is at E2 level. Increase in the income is more than the increase in investment. This shows that forward working of the multiplier. Next one is features of multiplier. Multiplier is associated with change in investment. As investment increases, multiplier investment also increase. As the investment decrease, our investment income will be, or investment multiplier will also be decreased. Second point is the size of multiplier depends upon the size of MPC. More we consume from our additional income, more will be the income, additional income we will get from the additional consumption. So the larger the MPC, the greater will be the size of multiplier, and vice versa. That is, K8 is equals to 1 upon 1 minus MPC. Third point is, there is direct relationship between MPC and multiplier. As MPC will increase, multiplier will also increase. Multiplier having inverse relationship with MPS. Next one is multiplier works in both directions, that is in forward and backward direction. Value of multiplier varies from unity to infinity. Now students, hope you have understood the topic of working of investment multiplier, and now it's time to note down the homework. Define the following terms with examples. First term is full employment, structural unemployment, frictional unemployment, disguised unemployment, cyclical unemployment, voluntary unemployment, involuntary unemployment, investment multiplier. Next question is, diagrammatically explain the relationship between multiplier and MPC. Also explain the working of multiplier and its features. And students, please go through the links on the YouTube for more clarity. Thank you for listening.